video news, yeah. It's TV video news.
Right, it's KP's video news, y'all. News flash. Garrett Roth charged with felony murder. That's right. In the Rayshard Brooks killing, Atlanta police officer Garrett Roth charged with felony murder plus 10 other crimes. This is a news flash. The prosecutor. Officer stood on Rayshard Brooks' shoulder, kicked him while he laid on the ground struggling for life. Garrett Roth, the former Atlanta police officer who fatally shot Rayshard Brooks in the back after the fleeing man pointed a stun gun in his direction, will be charged with felony murder plus 10 other crimes. Fulton County DA Paul Howard says Roth is being charged with 11 total charges, including felony murder, 3 counts of aggravated assault with a deadly weapon, criminal damage to property, violation of oath, and aggravated assault for kicking Rayshard Brooks as he lay dying of a gunshot wound. Officer Devin Brosnan has been charged with aggravated assault for standing on the body of Rayshard Brooks as he was dying. The DA says Brosnan has become a state's witness and agreed to testify against Roth. The DA says his office has issued an arrest warrant prior to the indictment of the Atlanta officers who killed Brooks. After viewing several videos, DA Paul Howard said Rayshard Brooks never presented himself as a threat. DA Howard also said the officers not only failed to render medical attention to Brooks after shooting him, one of them actually kicked him and the other stood on his shoulder after he'd been shot. After the officers shot Rayshard Brooks, the DA says one kicked him and the other stood on his shoulders while he was lying there fighting for his life. And let's see. So it's like, wow, man, they just really went through the motions. They really did the guy a job. 3 charges of aggravated assault and standing on Brooks' shoulder while he lay there dying. And it's like you shoot a man that's running away from you. Not only did the cop shot 3 times. He hit Brooks twice in the back, and then he hit another car that was waiting in line. So that was the third shot. So he was just reckless. He was just shooting his gun, man. He just shooting and shooting. He didn't even care for anybody's life at that point. He literally shot a car that was in the drive-through line. So it's like, wow, man. And the thing about it is, everybody got a camera these days. So while they was doing what they was doing, the people that was in their cars with their cameras and their phones was videotaping everything. They was like videotaping the whole thing. That's how they was able to get the pictures of the cops kicking him and the other cops standing on him while he lay there on the ground bleeding. So they said the DA District Attorney Howard also stated that this is the first time in Atlanta history that they had a cop that's willing to testify against another cop in a case like this. So this is some serious stuff going on down in Atlanta. So within 21 days, we've had 2 cops charged with murder. And you know what? Personally, I think this might be the way they need to do it. If a cop shoots somebody and you go through the motions, immediately fire that cop, immediately press charges, and then from there, if the cop beats the charges, then they can get their job back. But when you pull your gun out, especially if you're shooting somebody in the back, it's like I don't see what the defense is on that matter. Unless I got a gun. If I have a gun and I'm shooting at you and you shooting at me while I'm running away, and I'm just shooting back at you with a gun, then hey, that scene would probably be justifiable. But This guy had already been patted down. He didn't have a gun. They already knew he didn't have a weapon. They had already patted him down. They never read him his rights before they tried to attempt to handcuff him. And that's when he decided to start, you know, well, let me see what I got to do to try to get away. And we all know what happened after that. But he was never read his rights. He was never placed under arrest. So they tried to handcuff him before they even read him his rights or even told him the reason why they were handcuffing him. So, you know, wow, didn't expect this to happen this fast or this soon. However, as a follow-up story here, I'm going to do this story to add to that. It's a different situation. It's a black woman expert launches a program to train police officers on race and racism. Dr. Anita Davis, an academic and cross-cultural expert with over 20 years of experience in training and instruction, has launched Badges to Bridges, an online program that trains police officers on race and racism and anti-black racism. Dr. Davis, who is also the adjunct assistant professor in the Department of Cultural Geography at Canada's prestigious Queen's University, has designed her program to be offered as a Zoom webinar for 2 hours or live interactive training with uniform and command staff. The invaluable training program is customized to meet the various needs of police departments all across the country. Currently, the program is training officers on the topic of race, racism, and anti-black racism. Other topics are available, including policing African-American communities. Here are some of the benefits. Staff will gain confidence when working black and other racialized communities. Officers will be better prepared to de-escalate tense interactions based on cultural misunderstandings and miscues. And learners will gain increased confidence with community-based policing and during home visits, traffic stops, highway stops, and other face-to-face interactions. And you can find that on her official website. It's badgestobridges.com. And like I said, Anita Davies is an academic cross-cultural expert. 20 years of experience, and she's definitely, this what I just talked about right there is some type of training that if those cops had been trained like that down in Atlanta, this whole shooting never would have happened. It never would have happened. So, in reference to that, I was stating I want to do this town hall meeting, and I want to set it up. And that town hall meeting that I want to do is about delaying hiring war veterans. Basically, veterans that have just concluded like maybe two or three tours of duty, that's just coming back from Afghanistan since 1992 and the first Gulf War with Bush Sr. and then the second Gulf War with Bush Jr. and then eventually they created, you know, the Afghanistan situation kicked in, which has been going on for almost 20 years now. So the reason why I stated is that you have a lot of cops that are coming back from Afghanistan, and those ones that came back from Iraq, and people are trying to figure out, well, why are all these cops so trigger happy? Why are they shooting people so much? It's because you're hiring veterans that have just come straight from war, and they haven't had enough time to basically mentally de-escalate themselves from that killer mentality dealing with war. I think this, as a personal thing, I believe that they should give a 3 to 5 year moratorium on any veterans that have been active duty veterans that are coming back from Afghanistan, Iraq, or wherever they might be doing their active duty, and they should give them 3 to 5 years period time of going to get, if they want to become a cop, get some kind of mental evaluations. They need to be debriefed. They need to go through a series of psychological exams. And all this stuff needs to take time. It needs to take a period of 3 to 5 years so they can get all this killing out of their system before you turn around as a city and take those people and take that person out of that military uniform, give them a badge, and put them in a police uniform, and then you turn them loose on the people on the streets. You're not doing us any favors by militarizing the police departments in the United States. And if you ever watch shows on that feature cops on TV, when you look at the SWAT crew, the majority of those guys are snipers, military snipers, and you turn those guys loose majority of the time in the inner city. The outlying communities that are predominantly white, you don't even use those type of cops. But you use them daily when you're supposed to be doing these police raids for drugs and all that in the minority communities. So this stuff needs to stop. We don't need armored vehicles coming into the community, kicking people's doors down with AR-15 shooting. This is not... You've made it like the inner city is a battleground, and you're bringing troops, taking the troops out of the army uniform, and you're putting them in the police uniform with a badge. And this needs to stop, and it needs to be slowed down. You say, well, hey, 5 years, after your 5 years is up, then you can get that job being a cop. And that's just my personal opinion. KP's Video News, y'all.